Well, wearing a mask, of course, has become a heated debate across the country. As businesses Please. Have started to open up, we have seen many videos go viral of people refusing to wear a mask where they're required. The top complaints for those refusing to wear a mask cite not being able to breathe while wearing a mask, or that they don't want to wear one because they're rebreathing their exhaled carbon dioxide.
Yes.
Who says that? Who's ever said that?
Hmm.
Now, there's also the personal liberty argument that you've heard.
Sorry, or stinky breath.
That one, yeah.
I don't doubt that. Oh, we're gonna, okay, I thought, all right. Well, after seeing posts like this, Dr. Megan Hall, a pediatrician in South Carolina, posted on her Facebook and said, "For those of you who really believe the virus is penetrating the mask and you're breathing it in, how do you also believe your exhaled CO2 is getting stuck?" And then everyone was like, "Oh! Viruses need a vector to spread. COVID-19's vector is respiratory droplets. Those droplets aren't readily getting through a properly worn mask," she says.
And to prove, yes, and to prove her point against people complaining oxygen levels drop while wearing a mask, she conducted an experiment and posted pictures of herself on Facebook wearing no mask and three different masks for 5 minutes straight to see how they affected her heart rate and oxygen saturation levels. She also made note that immediately prior to the experiment, she had been wearing a surgical mask for 5 hours. The first picture of her with no mask shows her oxygen level at 98%, heart rate 64. The following pictures with different masks show her levels remain steady between 98 and 99, and her heart rate ranges between 64 and 69. "There is no significant change in my oxygen saturation or heart rate in any scenario, though maybe inconvenient for some. You can still breathe." That's what she said on Facebook. She concluded that post by saying, "As a physician, I urge you and ask you, please wear a mask to protect yourself and those who cannot safely wear a mask, like many of my patients who are under 2 years old."
Gotcha. Well, there you go, Robert. Although, you know, I wonder, I feel like a lot of people who aren't wearing masks and are using this as an excuse are probably not going, like, is anybody, would they believe anything? Doesn't matter if you saw it with your own eyes, they probably still wouldn't believe it.
Yeah.
All right, well, moving on, people are still working from home amid the pandemic, of course, and with the nice summer afternoons that we've been having.